You're listening to the TF Talk Network weekly TF Digest, where we give you the most relevant current stories in your fandom and more, all within 30 quick minutes or less. I'm your host, Mr. Starscream, and I'll be your guide to everything worth talking about that transformed since our last episode. This show is part of the TF Talk Podcast Network. Discover more of our great shows at tftalk.net. Hey, everybody, and welcome to this inaugural pilot episode of this new broadcast format for tftalk.net. The cast of TFYLP and I have been brainstorming and experimenting with new ways to build content for the TF Talk Network by breaking out recurring segments from the main TFYLP podcast and making separate smaller shows like this. This show is meant to be a quick snapshot of current events in Transformers fandom, such as conventions, notable fan interviews, media coverage, and announcements from Hasbro, but we will take a heavy focus on the toys and collector news, such as new releases, toy reveals, and sweet deals that can currently be taken advantage of. Expect recurring topic segments with a maximum of 2 minutes of coverage. It's all meant to be digested very quickly. We're not 100% sure how sustainable a show like this is, but we're going to give it a go and see what comes of it. In the meantime, you can follow TF Talk on Facebook and you can support us on Patreon at TFYLP. With that out of the way, we hope you enjoy the show, and we're going to roll right into our first segment, the reveal spiel. These days, it seems like new Transformers branded products pop up online in one form or another constantly. There's so much product, it's almost impossible to keep track of it all. And there's nothing worse than being late to the party and discovering a toy you had to have after it's already in the full swing of the dreaded aftermarket. Have no fear, though, because we are here to report on the latest toy reveals so you don't have to go hunting from site to site, making sure you're on the bleeding edge of what's coming next in Transformer Land. Although we are currently past the biggest flurries of summer toy reveals from Hasbro and Takara Tomy, there are a few examples of upcoming product that may not be on your radar just yet. The most recent reveals come to us from the Land of the Rising Sun as Takara Tomy Mall exclusives. The Transformers Encore line still functions, and yet another reissue of Beast Wars Neo Big Convoy is coming at us. This is the third reissue in less than 9 months of this mold from Takara Tomy, but this time it comes in a faithful original toy deco. If you're rolling your eyes at the concept of another woolly Maximal Commander, then you'll want to be aware that this is a special Matrix Buster edition of Big Convoy. This Matrix Buster canon defies the fundamental laws of decency as it appears to be more than half the size of the toy itself. Not to be forgotten, an add-on Navi figure is also included. Let's hope this is the last we'll be seeing of Big Convoy for some time, yeah? Forget prehistoric mammals for a second, and let's take a trip under the sea and catch a glimpse of some new robotic crustaceans originally forged in Japan. The second set of Generation Seacons were launched late last week and were promptly added to Hasbro Pulse days later. Retaining their original Japanese names, Lobclaw and Kraken, these heavy retools of the Power of the Primes Terracons are working hard for that higher price tag. Expected to release in February 2020, we can assume that we'll be seeing the final two Seacons revealed sometime in late September or early October with a March 2020 release date. Reveal spiel over. Upcoming toy reveals are great, but sometimes what's more important is the stuff you can get your hands on right now. This segment, titled On the Shelf, will focus on the latest retail sightings and any hot deals currently available from online retailers or chain stores that you just won't want to miss. Stay tuned for notifications on when and where you should gas up the car and put on your hunting gear, because it's big game season. One of the most recent steals out there right now is showing up at the tried and true discount outlet, Ollie's. Our very own Jim Black discovered a Studio Series release on deep discount just this week.
Hey everyone, Jim Black here of the TFYLP podcast. The Studio Series then and now 2-pack containing Studio Series 24 and 25 has been sighted recently in Tampa, Florida at Ollie's Bargain Outlet for $20. That is two Studio Series Deluxes in a 2-pack. For 20 bones. I myself have not seen it yet, but I will be checking my local Ollie's.
Moving to Target, the Siege Rainmaker set seems to be getting a bit of a restock at Targets across the country after a very dry launch run, so keep checking your local stores. Also worth noting is that Generation Select's Red Wing mysteriously disappeared off of Target.com as of August 31st. There had been a cryptic deadline stating that its red card exclusivity would end on the 31st, but what isn't clear is if that means it will become available for anyone to purchase on Target.com or simply disappear forever. And although it's not an actual sighting, the next big figure everyone's waiting for to pop on shelves is the Walgreens exclusive Siege Ratchet. This toy was revealed at San Diego Comic-Con, and strangely, it's appeared in Canada at Toys R Us without any notice. But Walgreens stock in the USA is being extra stubborn about appearing on shelf. If history is any indicator, Walgreens exclusive Transformers always hit in October, which is more than 3 weeks away. In the meantime, keep smashing that ratchet search on the Walgreens app or stop into your local Walgreens for frequent and repeated snack gathering trips. Oh, the collector's lament. When you find that grail you've been waiting days, months, or maybe even years to capture and fill a gaping hole in your collection, but it's already been sold. eBay is a dangerous place for vintage toy collectors, and once in a while, a rare unicorn may rear its beautiful head, only to be sniped at that last crucial second, and your completionist dreams dashed to bits. This collector-focused segment is titled, The One That Got Away, and we'll do our best to cover notable items that sold for crazy prices, or phantom items no one even knew existed. This one's for the Uber collector, and people that have been in it since the beginning. The first ever item to be featured in this segment is an odd one, and we don't really expect anyone to know what it is or why it sold for $380 on September 1st. The item in question is DairyCon 2005 exclusive Hot Stuff, a single mini-con that combines with two other similar mini-cons to become the Storm Sword. So I bet you're wondering, hey, Mr. Starscream, what the hell are you talking about? Dairy what? Well, if you could take a time machine back to 2005 and you were seriously into Armada and Transformers conventions, you might be one of the lucky few that was able to complete the Storm Sword, which required attendance at three different conventions from Wisconsin to the Netherlands. Each event had one piece of the Storm Sword as an exclusive. More information can be found on blog number 150 at imb3.net. Special thanks to Scotty P from the Sabertron.com Twincast for alerting me to this crazy item. If you come across a wild eBay auction or rare sales post, be sure to share it with TFYLP or TFTalk.net, and maybe it will get featured on an upcoming episode.
The one that got away.
I know. This might be crazy talk, but there's a lot more to Transformers than just the toys. Movies, comic books, flip books, video games, cartoons, neighborhood theater productions. If it's there to binge, we're gonna binge it. Forget little plastic dolls exist for the next 120 seconds and immerse yourself in TF fiction here and now. With an apparent embargo on any live-action film development news since New York Toy Fair 2019, the current running fiction discussions are centered around Season 2 of the fully animated Transformers Cyberverse cartoon that released its first two episodes this week, and the rebooted IDW Comics, which is set to launch a new series this month titled Transformers Galaxies. Galaxies is a spin-off series focusing on secondary and lesser-known characters. The first major story arc features a year-one background treatment to one of my personal favorite sub-teams, the Constructicons. Written by Transformers newcomer Tyler Blazinski and illustrated by veteran Livio Ramondelli, this story is meant to really flesh out the individual Constructicons and what it means for them to merge for the kill. I was lucky enough to meet Tyler in person at San Diego Comic-Con and talk face-to-face about how he brought each Constructicon to life on the page. I can guarantee these Decepticon bruisers are in good hands. There isn't an exact release date listed just yet, but it should be out this month, so reserve one at your local comic shop or online digital portal. As mentioned earlier, the new season of Cyberverse's first two episodes are supposed to be available on the Cartoon Network app. But the app simply didn't work on my Apple device. If you can find a way to view them, I have a feeling that Season 2 will be much more positively received by fans, and the episodes are super short, so give this series a second look. And that's the Fiction Report. Sure, we obviously love the official channels for the brand, but our fandom is vast, and we wouldn't want to alienate all the fanbro third-party toy enthusiasts out there. No way. It's third party time, and this is when we discuss reveals and recently released unofficial transforming toys. Put your black hats on and join the party. The biggest waves in third party toys are currently being made by Zeta Toys, who is poking the bear with one of the largest sticks I've ever seen. After a handful of teaser photos last month, the company has gone full bore and released gray model photos of their own Unicron figure named ZV02 Core Star. Beyond the obvious comparisons to the currently funding HasLab Unicron, which we will touch upon later in this program, Core Star is advertised to include die-cast parts, LEDs, and a head height of 48 centimeters. While that is quite a tall figure, it is still dwarfed by the prospective HasLab version. Features include a removable head, rotating planet spikes, and a fully transformable robot mode that seems to lack pronounced kibble or paneling of any kind. While there are definitely some visible drawbacks to Zeta Toy's design as currently shown, the toy is an eye-catcher and is positioned as a cheaper alternative to the official other release. The timing of this reveal seems opportunistic at best, and with current rumors of lawsuits involved with some of the overseas third-party companies, it's hard for this host not to wonder if Zeta Toys might be wearing a set of Icarus wings. However, the figure is touted to release in December of this year and is currently up for pre-order at third-party staples TF Direct and Show Z store. I mean, if I had to put my two cents in, I think the toy looks pretty cool, but that planet mode doesn't so much look like a planet as it looks like something else. This fine real estate situated smack dab in the middle of our program is brought to you by No One. If you are interested in reaching engaged pop culture podcast listeners, then boy, do we have a deal for you. Sponsorship inquiries can be made via email by reaching out to podcast@tfylp.com. Reach out to us and see if we can strike up a deal. And now, back to the show. Newsflash, Transformers are super cool. But the world doesn't just spin around Cybertron. At least not without some help. It's a big pop culture world out there, and we plan to dedicate 10% of this show to non-Transformers topics that a majority of our listeners find relevant to their interests, at least we hope. If you can't stomach anything but bots and cons, then feel free to skip the remaining 90 seconds of this segment and call it a day. We're not quite sure when this episode will air, quote-unquote, but as of this recording, we are on the precipice of the release of Chapter 2 of Stephen King's It films. This film bookends the modern rebooted horror story and picks up almost 30 years from the last film, and it follows the main characters, now adults, as they take on the nefarious entity plaguing the town of Derry, Maine. Initial reviews are mixed, but performances by the all-star cast are being universally praised, especially Bill Skarsgård's interpretation of the evil clown Pennywise. If you're ready to say goodbye to summer and hello to fall in a way that welcomes the upcoming spooky Halloween season, then It Chapter 2 is a great option to spend a few hours this coming weekend. In other movie news, the ongoing Spider-Man wars between Sony and Disney appear to be hitting Peter Parker pretty hard. Multiple news outlets are quoting Sony as saying, "The door is closed" on Spider-Man returning to the Marvel Cinematic Universe. This hits no one harder than billionaire Tony Stark, who has been heard rolling in his grave after saving half the known universe, yet still losing the kid again. In a post-Game of Thrones world, many Khaleesi turncoats have been struggling to find a new fantasy world to escape into. Following the highly acclaimed superhero drama The Boys, Amazon Video has doubled down on exclusive content with Carnival Row, which came online this past week. I haven't had a chance to watch it myself, but I follow Cara Delevingne on Instagram, so I'm gonna watch it. So this was a big week in Transformers fandom, and unless you were living under a rock, you definitely heard about the new release in Japan, MP44, Convoy Version 3. I'm here to talk with the Hobby Drifter, who lives in Japan, and was able to give us our first English review of the toy right out of the box.
Hey everybody, this is the Hobby Drifter. I'm originally from Chicago, but I've been living all over Japan for the last 13 years. Just this week, the Masterpiece 44 Optimus Prime Convoy 3.0 came out, and so this was an annoyingly mandatory purchase. So I just wanted to share my honest, unrehearsed opinions about the figure. When I made the thing public, it became my most viewed video on the entire channel within just a couple of days. And I got to connect with a whole bunch of people who were really excited for this. Transforming that thing was an adventure. I think Masterpiece 44 Optimus Prime 3.0 is a brilliant figure. It is an incredible piece of engineering. The amount of effort and technical skill that went into making it is almost unthinkable. It is immensely complicated. It's going to be interesting to see if this is where Transformers, especially high-priced Masterpiece figures, are going in the future. And if you like it, I'm right there with you. If you don't, I completely understand. But I think everyone should agree that the fact that this thing exists and was released at mass retail by Takara Tomy is just unbelievable, and we should be thankful that this kind of thing is an option.
I want to thank Hobby Drifter for coming on the show and discussing his review of MP44. We'll be sure to reach out to him for any Japanese correspondence in the future. In the meantime, you can find his MP44 review on his YouTube channel, simply titled Hobby Drifter, and follow him on Twitter at Hobby Drifter. And now we'd like to have a convention conversation. Any longtime Transformers fan sooner or later learns that the conventions are where it's at. And in the post-BotCon aftermath, we've all been spread to the wind like so many ashes. So we are taking it upon ourselves here at the TF Talk Network to dedicate a segment of this show to the next upcoming Transformers conventions. The next one up to bat is TFCon USA DC, which is fast approaching at the end of October. Returning to Reston, Virginia for its sophomore year, TFCon USA DC promises to be jam-packed as the hotel block and dealer tables are completely sold out. New guests are being announced regularly as the event draws near. This convention is more than two full days, Friday, October 25th through the 27th. If you've never been to a TFCon, well, I gotta say, it's the closest thing to BotCon that we've ever had. There's a massive dealer room with all the companies you've grown accustomed to buying from online over the years. There's amazing panels. It's very organized. There's tons of guests. There's always a surprise or two. It's just a really good time. You might even get a chance to put a face to some of these voices that you've been listening to week after week on TFYLP and the rest of the TFTalk.net shows. Some recently announced guests include Aaron Archer, Alex Milne, Paul Eiding, and that's just the few. Attendee tickets, up-to-date schedules, guests, and exclusives are all easily accessible at tfcon.com. We want to feature a real Transformers convention in this slot every episode, so if we missed yours somehow, please get in touch with us so we can present your event in the best light possible. Reach out to us via social media channels, and we'd love to feature your event in the space. Maybe we can even have a convention conversation. He's big, he's bad, and he's still being funded at Hasbro Pulse. This is Unicron Watch, a special segment where we follow the progress of the currently developing story surrounding this monumental Transformers figure. In case you weren't aware of the details, Hasbro has conceived of a giant, very G1 looking update to Unicron. This is meant to be the flagship toy of the War for Cybertron trilogy. Weighing over 19 pounds and standing at 29 inches tall, perhaps the most shocking feature of this toy is the price tag. At a whopping $575, Hasbro is looking for 8,000 committed backing purchases within 45 days, or else this toy will become nothing more than wishful thinking. Fast forward to 2 days before the last funding deadline, August 31st, the project was about 2,800 backers short of its goal when Hasbro announced the deadline would be extended an additional 36 days to the end of New York Comic Con on October 6th. I decided to let a fellow cast member weigh in on this extension announcement.
Hey, this is Rob, part of the TF Talk Network, a host of Ouch My Wallet on Wednesdays. There were many complaints of when it came out, you know, people saying we need more time because of all the other pre-orders that went up at the same time. It's been a very expensive summer for Transformer collectors, and I think it's a smart move from Hasbro's side because it wasn't going to fund, at least not naturally. They saw that and they reacted appropriately. I think that's the only move they could have made other than just, you know, completely fudging the numbers or saying, oh, it didn't happen later, which I don't think anybody expects this to not be made. I'm definitely backing Unicron, and, you know, I pretty much immediately backed it. You know, I'm looking forward to it, even though I have gripes and complaints about it.
As of this recording, Unicron has more than 31 full days to acquire 2,400 more purchases in order to reach its funding goal. Some quick math dictates that 77 units per day need to be sold in order for it to become fully backed by the 6th of October. We'll check in with Unicron next week as Unicron Watch continues. We're sprinting towards the end of the show, but before we close out, we want to make sure to give you some vital intel on all of the other amazing shows that round out the TF Talk Network. First and foremost is our flagship roundtable podcast that is broadcast live on Facebook and YouTube every Sunday evening. This is TFYLP, aka Transformers for Your Listening Pleasure. Hosted by Lucas Bachelman, this show features an ensemble cast that rotates in and out every week to discuss timeless topics that should interest Transformers fans of all shapes, sizes, and factions. Then there's Ouch My Wallet, also broadcast live in video on Wednesday nights, hosted by Rob, who you heard from in the last segment. This is where cast members discuss recent purchases and give only the hottest of takes. There's also Cut the Tape, a new pre-recorded video show conducted by Rick Alvarez. Hardcore vintage toy lovers will salivate over the treasures Rick devalues before your very eyes. Look out for new episodes intermittently throughout the week in the TF Talk stream. And joining me now is regular cast member Christian, who wants to tell you about our first spinoff show, Microcasters, streaming live Tuesday nights.
Hi everyone, my name is Christian. You guys might know me from TFYLP Microcasters. It's a live show that airs Tuesdays at 10 p.m. Eastern, where we spend about half an hour to 45 minutes covering recent figures. Like the new Siege Repaint exclusives, we cover the Rainmakers, we cover the Firestormer pack and the Phantom Strike Squadron in another episode. And we also do third-party legends on a pretty regular basis. If you want to talk to us in real time, we'll answer you in real time. We're broadcast live on YouTube. Leave us a comment, and we'll talk directly to you. On Microcasters, you can find me, Lucas, our host, and Anna, our other contributor. We're a pretty steady team of three, and we're the ones who talk to you every week. We hope to catch you live on Tuesday nights at 10 p.m. Eastern or 9 p.m. Central, live on YouTube.
Thank you, Christian. And remember to visit tftalk.net for more information on all our shows. Whew. Well, that's the show. Our very first one, the pilot episode. Will we get picked up for a full season? That's up to you, the listeners of tftalk.net. Please give us your feedback wherever you can and let us know if you want to hear more. We're going to leave you with a moment of zen from today's special guest, the Hobby Drifter.
35 年前、今より、感動は最高ですね。3、2、1、トランスフォーム!
Thanks for listening, and this is Mr. Starscream signing off. This show is so new, we don't even have a name for it yet. Do you have a good idea for a name or want to give us some feedback? You can email us at podcast@tfylp.com or leave a comment on the tftalk.net Facebook page. The TF Talk Network exists from the efforts of an enthusiastic collection of Transformers fans all across North America and beyond. The concept was created by Duran Land, and the main show, TFYLP, has continued for over 10 years. The cast at the TF Talk Network is always growing, so if you have a desire to participate, reach out to us via any of our social platforms, although the TF Talk Facebook page is currently the most active. You can directly support the podcast and keep it on air by becoming a monetary supporter of TFYLP on Patreon. Donations to Patreon are used to cover expenses incurred by running the shows and are not distributed to any individual staff members. TF Talk is not affiliated with Hasbro, Paramount Pictures, Takara Tomy, or any other brands. It is 100% fan-created content.
I was flipping. I was like, 75 steps? Holy God.